Here's the first part of my vending machine interface where the clock is now working. I've now set up my first register. So whenever the clock is high and I switch from ground to high or high to ground, this LED right here will follow suit. So right now it's low, high, low. And you can see it transitions only when the clock is high. Here we have my final vending machine circuit. Over here we have five LEDs corresponding to, in ascending order, 5, 10, 20, 40, and 80 cents. And when the light is lit up, it means that total can be added to your sum. So for example, if all of the lights are lit up, it would be 80 plus 40 plus 20 plus 10 plus 5, which I think is 155. I'll do the math on that one. So I've got this hooked up to the vending machine. And right now the quarter sensor isn't working. Russ is over here fixing that right now. And to emulate the quarter being inserted into the machine, I've just wired VCC to, I'll put it into the quarter sensor whenever I want a quarter to come out. So I'll take that out. So first I'm going to insert a dime. And what you do is you put it up here, goes into the little thing, and it lit up. So that's 10 cents because the second LED is lit up. This is really a binary counter that counts up to 12, but if you multiply it by 5, you can get the full total. So that was one dime. I'm going to put it in a few more times to show you how it counts. Oh, jeez. Sometimes it takes some time. See, now it went up to 20. And now add 10 more. So right now we're at 30 cents. So now I'm gonna add some nickels. This is my nickel. It's not really a nickel, but we don't have a nickel. So it's going down, it skips this one, goes into here. And now the first one lit up because that's the 5 cents. And I'm gonna do that one more time. Push it along, it skips over the dime, and then it slides down. Oh, it's stuck. So now we're at 40 cents. For my vending machine to work, you need 60 cents. So I'm just gonna put in two more dimes. So that go through. Sometimes it doesn't sense. There's one. So now I have 60 cents. So when you press this little button right here and you have 60 cents, the chocolate will come out of the vending machine. So I will now show you. I'm going to press the button and there's my chocolate. And here we go. We've got the chocolate. And you can see that the total has reset to zero because I spent 60 cents. But if you insert more than 60 cents, it will hold the remainder if after you subtract 60. So now let's pretend I'm putting in a quarter. The quarter goes down, and I'm gonna use this wire here to simulate the quarter's rising edge. So I'll show you. So now it sensed the quarter, and now it doesn't sense it. So that added 25 cents. I'm gonna do it two more times. That didn't work for some reason. There we go. So now that should be 50 cents if you add up the lights. And one more. That's 75 cents right there, which is enough to vend the chocolate. So I'm gonna put it back in. And now I'm going to vend. Got another chocolate. And we still have cents left. So I think I added wrong before. I think that was really a dollar because now this is 40 cents. And now I'm going to show you how, when it does not have 60 cents, it will not vend. I'm pressing the button. Nothing's happening. And right now we're at 40 cents. I was wrong before when I said we had 75 cents. I accidentally inserted an extra quarter. So now we have 40 cents left over from that dollar after vending. So now I'm going to put in two more dimes to bring the total right to 60. That's 10. Still doesn't vend. One more dime. And now we have 60 cents and we vend. And ladies and gentlemen, that's the vending machine. Thank you. Since it was kind of hard to see how inserting dimes, nickels, and quarters impacted my circuit in the original video, right now I'm going to show you a controlled setting where I manually set the inputs from the coin scanners. I'm going to wire them directly to VCC to show you how they do, in fact, change the values by 5, 10, and 25. So first I'm going to start with a nickel. You can see over here, I put it in. That's the positive. And on the falling edge, that adds 5 cents. And now I'm going to do it again. And again. You can see that it's counting by 5. So that right there is 20 cents. Now I'm gonna count by 10 using the dime. There's 10, there's another 10. So now we're at 40, I'm gonna add 60 more. I'm gonna make it go to 60, I mean. So now I'm at 60 cents, and that's enough to vend. So when I press the button, it takes it out. And you can see in my video how when I have enough and I press the button, it causes it to vend. So now I'm going to show you that when I press the button, it doesn't vend. It doesn't subtract 60 cents from my total. It only subtracts 60 cents when I have 60 cents. Otherwise, it remains in idle. So now I'm going to show you quarter because the quarter scanner wasn't working. So that added 25 and there's a dollar. See? And then I'm just going to keep on adding. And you can see it overflows. I didn't put in any restriction as to how high it could go. So if you put in more than $1.55, sorry. You just gotta put in some more money. So right now we have 15. So if I add a quarter, that should add us up to 40, which is just the third light, the fourth light, I'm sorry. So now we're at 40. I'm gonna add two more dimes. So now we're at 60, and we vend. And I'm gonna do it one more time. I'm gonna put in 50 cents. So there's 50. And I'm pressing the vend button, but nothing's happening. Not even if I put in a 5. Putting in 5 cents doesn't vend. But once we put in that 60th cent, it vends. And that is a more in detail description of how the inputs affect the counter.